Hey guys, welcome to Akash tutorial, and today the topic we will be dealing is Kreb cycle. So what is Kreb cycle? So Kreb cycle, it is one of the most important pathway for energy productions. It is also known as citric acid cycle, and it is also known as tricarboxylic acid cycle due to involvement of three carboxylic acids. They are citrate, isocitrate, and cis aconitate. And this cycle is named in the honor of scientist Hans Adolf Kreb, who described this cycle in 1937 AD. And it is the major pathway for energy productions. That's why 60 to 75% of total ATP is produced by this process. And it is the most common and important pathway for glucose, fatty acid, and protein metabolism, because all of the intermediates are finally being catabolized to acetyl coenzyme A, and via Kreb cycle it is oxidized to carbon dioxide and water. A large amount of energy is released in the form of ATP or NADH or FADH too. So this is all about the Kreb cycle's overview. And the site, where does it occur? It occurs in mitochondrial matrix. So the enzyme necessary for Kreb cycles are also present in mitochondrial matrix. Now going on to the steps of the Kreb cycles. So as we have discussed glycolysis and oxidative decarboxylation in our previous videos, so the product of oxidative decarboxylation is two carbon compounds. That is acetyl coenzyme A. It will react with oxaloacetate in the presence of citrate synthase to form, it is a two carbon compound and it is a four carbon compound. It will form six carbon compound, that is citric acid or citrate. It is a six carbon compound. Now citric acid, if we see the structure of citric acid, here is the structure. It is a six carbon compound. So we can see there is tertiary alcohol. In the tertiary carbon there is a presence of hydroxy group, and the presence of tertiary hydroxyl group in the citric acid makes it harder to oxidize. Similarly, if it is present in the citrate and if it reacts with the aconitase, then in subsequent reaction the CO2 that will be released from the oxaloacetate, not from the acetyl CO. So oxaloacetate cannot be regenerated and the Kreb cycles will not occur. So in order to overcome the position of tertiary hydroxyl group, it is isomerized. So isomerized, first of all, for isomerization, it is dehydrated in the presence of enzyme aconitase. So it will form cis aconitate. So we will again dehydrate it. So after dehydration, a water molecule is lost, OH from here and H from here. So it will form now after that we again rehydrate it in the presence of same enzyme aconitase. Now it will form isocitrate, but the position of tertiary hydroxyl group is being changed into secondary hydroxyl group, so the structure will become like this. So the problem of releasing of carbon dioxide and the subsequent reactions from the oxaloacetate is overcome by the presence of econitase enzyme, because it will dehydrate it to form cis econitrate and again rehydrate to form isocitrate. So this is the rearrangement form of reaction. Now this reaction is inhibited by a compound known as fluoroacetate. For sake of clarity, I will be writing in blue color. So fluoroacetate, what happens? It will react with oxaloacetate to form oxalocitrate. Oxalocitrate will inhibit fluorocitrate. So formed will inhibit econitase. So the reaction of Kreb cycle cannot be formed. ATP is not formed and it is a suicide inhibitor. It is a suicide inhibitor. Acts as non-competitive inhibitor. Now, then isocitrate will be changed into oxalosuccinate. And it is a dehydrogenase reaction. And it occurs in the presence of isocitrate dehydrogenase. As it is a dehydrogenase reaction, so from NAD plus NADH is generated. Now oxaloacetate only acts as an intermediate. It will soon, and these all are reversible form of reactions. This is also a reversible form of reaction. But now from here, it is a 6-carbon compound. It will release a molecule of carbon dioxide. Occurs in the presence of same enzyme, isocitrate dehydrogenase. This enzyme is a complex and mainly depends on NAD plus in mitochondria and NADH in both dependent in cytoplasm and mitochondria. So carbon dioxide is released. Now it will form alpha ketoglutarate. Now alpha ketoglutarate, it is a 5-carbon compound and it is an irreversible reaction. Now alpha ketoglutarate will again lose a molecule of carbon dioxide, and also, and here NADH is generated and the compound so formed is succinyl coenzyme A. In the presence of enzyme alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, and this enzyme is analogous to pyruvate dehydrogenase. In our previous lecture we have seen that pyruvate dehydrogenase is dependent on five cofactors. They are lipoamide, coenzyme A, FAD, NAD, and thiamine diphosphate or pyrophosphate. So this enzyme is also dependent upon these five factors. So the coenzyme A is being substituted. So succinyl COA is formed. As a CO2 is being released, so it is also oxidative decarboxylation step. Now it will form 4-carbon compound, and this is also irreversible form of reaction. Now succinyl coenzyme A, it will release coenzyme A that is gained here, and this is an exothermic reaction. So from GDP it will form GTP in the presence of enzyme succinyl thiokinase. as the GTP is generated without or without going into the electron transport chain. So this is also a substrate level phosphorylations. What is it also? Substrate level phosphorylations. Now from succinyl thiokinase, what is formed? Is succinate. Succinate is formed. Now from succinate, it will also undergo the from reversible, that is a dehydrogenation reactions. In the presence of enzyme, succinyl dehydrogenase. And here the FAD is changed into FADH2. A molecule of FADH2 is generated over here. Now from fumarate. Now what is formed? Here fumarate is formed. Now fumarate will undergo a hydration reactions. Hydration reaction that will form malate. In the presence of enzyme, fumarate. Now, malate will again undergo a dehydrogenation reactions. So whenever there is dehydrogenations, so NADH is formed in the presence of enzyme, malate dehydrogenase. So this is all the Kreb cycles. So Kreb cycles mainly concerned with the regeneration of oxaloacetate and the oxidations of acetyl coenzyme in the form of 2-carbon dioxide. So this is Kreb cycles. Now we can calculate the generations of 3 NADH. Three molecule of NADH. And one molecule of NADH will give 2.5 ATP. So that is 7.5 ATP. One molecule of FADH2. So that is 1.5 ATP. And one GTP via substrate level phosphorylations. So it will become 10 ATP according to the new concept. So Kreb cycles. So Kreb cycle is associated with the generation of 10 ATP. Now what are the vitamins that are mainly associated with Kreb cycles? So mainly vitamin B complex. B complex is associated with Kreb cycles. So what are the name of these vitamins? So first of all, thiamine. Thiamine. So we can see thiamine is mainly associated with alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. Second one is niacin. Whenever there is NAD plus is used or regenerated or being used up, so niacin is involved in that reactions. Third one is riboflavin. Whenever there is involvement of FAD plus flavin adenine dinucleotide, then there is involvement of riboflavin. And last one is pantothenic acid. In pantothenic acid, there is involvement of coenzyme A. So four vitamin complexes are being used in Kreb cycles, and it is often known as amphibolic pathway. Amphibolic pathway, because both anabolic and catabolic reactions occur in the Kreb cycles. And it is not a closed cycle, it is an open cycle, because various intermediates can come and exit from this cycle, but I have not shown over here. An amphibolic pathway, because alpha ketoglutarate is changed into another amino acids for productions of various non-essential amino acids. Similarly, succinyl coenzyme is also changed into another amino acids. So it is a amphibolic pathway, not a only concerned with anabolic. There occurs both anabolism and catabolism. So this all is about Kreb cycles. I hope you will understand it, and we will be dealing with the electron transport chain in next video. Thank you.